Good morning, students. Coming to this next concept, so everyone has to understand. Biot-Savart's law. So what is the use of this Biot-Savart's law? So listen carefully. In the previous class I told you, we know very well Oersted experiment. So a scientist named Oersted, he find one thing. So what is that? Current carrying connectors produce magnetic field around it. Current carrying connectors produce magnetic field around it. Now scientist, and in the previous class I explained how to find the direction of magnetic field formed by this current carrying connectors. So now what is the magnitude of that magnetic field? So what is the magnitude of that magnetic field? So this is Biot-Savart's law. Magnitude of that magnetic field we want. So how to find the magnitude of magnetic field? So many laws are there. So Biot-Savart's law is one of the law. So this is a special thing, just you have to remember, very important concept it is. Suppose man lijiye, here is a current carrying connector, any shape you can take. So M N is the current carrying connector I am taking here. M N is the current carrying connector. So there is, so current is flowing through it. So I am considering current I is flowing through the straight wire, through this connector. So around this current carrying connector you will get a magnetic field. So here is a point P. So at this point P, what is the magnetic field given by this current carrying connector? So this is our aim. How to find magnetic field at this point P? So listen carefully what we have to do. Consider a small element of length dl. Consider an element of length dl, small element. Total length is from M to N, but I am considering small element. In this also current is flowing. So it is called current element. It is called current element like this. It is called current element. So length is dl. So element is, current element is like this. So join this current element to the point required, P point P here. So join these two. So this is called current element of length dl. Remember this terminology. So total wire is giving magnetic field. But first of all, what we are doing, small element, how much magnetic field is giving here? Element is giving some magnetic field. First of all, we will find the magnetic field given by the element. So this is the line joining the element and point P. So the distance is r here, small r. Small r is the distance. So angle between the element and the line joining the point to the element, so it makes an angle theta here. So this is the angle theta. So this theta is the angle between the current element and line joining the element and point. Now this small element of length dl, it gives a small magnetic field at this point P. So Biot and Savart, they are giving the magnetic field at this point P, which is given by the element. First element, how much magnetic field is giving? Listen the statement. Magnetic field due to the current element. Magnetic field due to a current element. Number one. Magnetic field due to a current element. Number one. Is directly proportional to the strength of current. dB proportional to I. Current I. Directly proportional to length of the element. Length of the element, dB proportional to dl. Next, directly proportional to, listen carefully, sine of the angle between the element, current element, and a line joining the element and point. Line joining the element and point. Sin theta, S-I-N, sin theta. And fourth one, dB is proportional to 1 by r square, inversely proportional to square of the distance between the element and point. Inversely proportional to square of the distance between the element and point. dB proportional to 1 by r square. Inversely proportional to square of the distance between the element and point. So this is the thing. So combining all these things, finally the magnetic field induction into the element proportional to, so here current I is there, element dl, sin theta is there, whole by r square. This is the thing. Remove that proportionality, you will get a constant. In the magnetism generally you will get a magnetic proportionality constant will be, this is a mu 0 by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. So this is the magnetic field induction due to the current element. So remember, you will get the doubts, remember this is the magnetic field. And we can write it in the vector form also. We can write it in the vector form also, remember. Vector form, magnetic field dB bar is equal to, so mu 0 by 4 pi. Listen carefully what we are doing. Mu 0 by 4 pi. This is ideal sin theta. So ideal sin theta. Ideal sin theta. Ideal sin theta by r square. So here multiply and divide with r and r. So this is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi. I dl r sin theta by, this is nothing but r cube. So this one you can see like AB sin theta, 11th class concept. This is a mu 0 by 4 pi I. So this is nothing but dl bar cross r bar. dl bar cross r bar. This is the point. This is the length, na? So length dl bar it is. Length dl bar cross r bar. So whole by r cube. So this is the vector form, remember. This is the magnetic field dB bar is equal to, this is the formula. dl bar cross r bar. dl bar cross r bar. This is the formula. I told you theta is the angle between element dl and the line joining the element and point. R is there now, so beach my angle theta. So now coming to the one more important point. This is the magnetic field given by the small element dl only. But I want the magnetic field given by total conductor from M to N. So now total magnetic field. Total magnetic field. I want B value. So you have to, so small element is giving a dB here. Another element is giving a dB here. Another element is giving a dB here. A dB, dB, dB you have to add. So adding is nothing but integration. Integral dB. Integration is from M to N, remember. Integration is from M to N. B is equal to integral M to N dB. So this is the sentence. That is the total magnetic field, remember. So remember total magnetic integration. And here, what is this mu naught? Mu naught is nothing but permeability of free space. Mu naught is nothing but permeability. Just like in electricity, permittivity is there. Here, permeability of free space. That means it is allowing the magnetic lines of force. So mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 power of minus 7 Henry per meter. So this is a mu naught value. Then automatically, what is my mu naught by 4 pi value? 10 power of minus 7 Henry per meter. Constant it is. Remember? So in the numericals, we are using this sentence. So this is about Biot-Savart's law. Now coming to the application of this Biot-Savart's law. Very, very important. In our syllabus, we have one application on the basis of this Biot-Savart's law. So listen carefully, I will explain. What is that application? Magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop. Magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop, that is the application. Listen carefully. So application of Biot-Savart's law. So magnetic field due to current carrying circular loop. Current carrying circular loop. Here also two cases are there. First case is on the axial line. So axial line of circular current carrying loop. Actually on the axial line. What is this on the axial line? On the axis, na? So we will see how to explain this thing. Listen carefully. Consider this is a circular loop like this. This is a circular loop. Okay. So it consists of n number of turns and radius of each turn is R, capital R I am taking. Radius of each turn is capital R. So man lijiye current I is flowing through it here. Current I is flowing. Okay. Radius is R. So this is the center point. What do you mean by axial line? The horizontal line passing through the center like this, na? So this is called horizontal, this is called axial line. So horizontal line passing, this is called axial line like this, axial line. So now what we have to do at a point on the axial line. So where is that point? Any point you can take on the axial line. So consider here I am taking a point P. At this point P, I want the magnetic field given by this current carrying circular loop. So that is why what I am considering here, this is the point P. This is the point P, which is at a distance x from the center of the current carrying loop. How much distance I am taking here? Distance x from the current carrying loop like this. Center, from center to the point, it is x distance. Now what we have to do, consider a small element on the current carrying loop, that is the element of length dl. So dl is the element, already current is flowing, that is why this is called current carrying element of length dl. So the distance between the current carrying element and this point is, what is the element distance here? This distance is x. This distance is R. Apply Pythagoras theorem, you will get the distance is root of R square plus X square. After some time I will use this sentence. Root of, square root of, under root R square plus X square. Check it. So this is the value, under root R square plus X square. This is the value. That is the distance here. Now coming to this sentence, here is also another element is there, so it is also current carrying element, same length is dl, same thing. Niche bhi here also one more element is there like this. So it is giving a magnetic field at this point P, it is also giving magnetic field at this point P. Now listen carefully. So this is the current carrying element which gives magnetic field dB, small element is giving small magnetic field. So this is the direction of magnetic field given by current carrying element like this. This is a dB. So it is giving like this. Maybe you will get doubts also. Sir, how can you say that it is giving magnetic field in this direction only? Very simple. Just apply right hand thumb rule. You will get the idea. Apply right hand thumb rule, you will get the idea how the magnetic field, it is coming like this. Now it is anti-clockwise direction, you can see anti-clockwise direction, so you will understand like this. This is the fingers, na? So see, my fingers are like this. So here also this element is giving magnetic field, so it is also in this direction. So this is also dB, like this dB. Okay, na? So this is the point P. Now this element and this point P, the line makes an angle phi at the center. Consider, I am considering the line joining the element and point makes an angle phi with the axis like this. Now here students will get some doubts, listen carefully. So draw the perpendicular line like this. Try to understand. Here is angle phi, the remaining angle becomes 90 minus phi. This angle becomes phi. So see this mathematical techniques. Here is angle phi. Okay, na? So here also angle becomes phi. Symmetric hota hai na? So here also angle becomes phi. So if it here is phi, here angle becomes 90 minus phi. So phi, this is 90 minus phi. So again reverse, here again you will get angle phi like this. Angle phi like this. So here is angle phi, here is also angle phi. Everybody knows magnetic field is a vector quantity. Magnetic field is a vector quantity. So that vector quantity is making some angle phi with this line. So what we have to do? 11th class concept. So we have to follow resolution of vector. So dB can be resolved into two components. So how to resolve here? Check it carefully. So dB makes an angle phi with this line. So along this line, you will get cos component, dB cos phi. Perpendicular, you will get sine component, dB sine phi. Listen carefully. Similarly, dB makes an angle phi with this line. So here also you will get cos component, dB cos phi. Perpendicular, you will get again dB sine phi. So this is the sentence. dB sin phi, both are in the same direction. That means in this current carrying loop, all dB sin phi components are in the same direction. So you can add up, they will give total magnetic field. Now, listen carefully. So using Biot-Savart's law. Now I am using Biot-Savart's law. So what I am doing, dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. Here students will get theta doubt. Listen carefully. Theta means this is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I dl sin theta means, check it, theta means, I told you, if you remember in the Biot-Savart's law, angle between the element and the line joining the element, not here. I want this angle between the element line and line joining the element and point. So this angle is how much? Mathematics technique, it is just like a tangent, always perpendicular to the radius. So that is why this theta becomes 90 degree. So sine 90 degree, remember, by r square. Don't confuse this theta and this phi, both are different. So this is sine 90 degree. Sine 90 means 1. So finally you will get dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I dl by r square. So this is a dB value, remember. Okay. So here r square means distance square, na? So from the figure, distance square means this is the distance square. So this is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I dl. Distance square means root of r square plus x square whole square. Okay, na? So square and root cancel. Finally, you will get mu 0 by 4 pi I dl. So this is r square plus x square. That root cancel. Okay, na? That is dB value. Now I want total magnetic field. Total magnetic field given by the circular loop. So I told you previously also, first we will find the field due to the small element dB, and to get total field we have to integrate, we have to add. Total magnetic field B is equal to, total magnetic field B is equal to. So how you will get the total magnetic field, how much? Just by integrating like this. So total magnetic field B is equal to, so adding of this small magnetic fields, integral dB like this. B is equal to integral dB. So B is equal to integral dB value, just now I have written mu 0 by 4 pi I dl by r square plus x square. So constants you can take outside. So here dB sin phi na it is. Integral dB sin phi. I told you here dB sin phi, dB sin phi, dB sin phi. So here also sin phi is there, remember. dB value we know very well, sin phi is there. Check it, dB sin phi components we have to add. So this implies B is equal to this constant mu 0 by 4 pi I dl by r square plus here dl is also inside, you have to kept. This is I by r square plus x square can be taken outside. Integral dl of sin phi, it is remaining. Integral dl of sin phi. So from this figure, what is sin phi value? Sin phi is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So check it. This is a mu 0 by 4 pi I by r square plus x square. Okay na? Integral dl. Sin phi means what is sin phi value? That is opposite side r. Hypotenuse is root of r square plus x square. Listen carefully. This is r by this value is you can bring outside constant. So this is a mu 0 by 4 pi I by r square plus x square, and this root r square plus x square, and r is also there, integral dl like this. So this is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi I r by, this is root means power 1 by 2, root means power 1 by 2. So this is power 1, no power 1 by 2. So if you add the powers, you will get r square plus x square whole power, this is 3 by 2 you will get. And integral dl, integral dl means, look at the diagram, this is a dl, this is a dl. So all dl, 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 dl you can add. So integral dl is nothing but, integral dl is nothing but, can you guess from the figure, integral dl, all the elements you can add, which is equal to circumference, which is equal to how much? Circumference. So circumference of the circle formula kya hai? So this is equal to 2 pi r. 2 pi r is the circumference of the circle. 2 pi r. So this is the circumference of the circle. But here the problem is, one circle is there, you can write 2 pi r. But here so many circles are there, I told you. N number of turns are there. N number of turns are there. This is 2 pi r. N number of turns are there. If only one circle is there, okay, you can write 2 pi r. If n number of turns are there, what you have to write? So n, sorry, capital R na, radius is capital R. So this is n number of turns are there, you have to write n into 2 pi r. So this is the important point. N into 2 pi r is the important point. So that is the total length of the element here. N into 2 pi r. So this is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi n I is there. If you want here cancellation also, 2 pi 2 cancel hota hai na, 2 pi 2 and cancel hota hai. So finally you will get here cancel mu 0, n is there, okay na, I is there, r into r, r square, mu 0 n I r square whole by, already I told you 2 pi 2 times cancel, 2 off. So this is r square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. So this is the magnetic field. this is the magnetic field value on the axial line. फिर से बोलो, what is this Kepler? Radius of the circular path. R means radius of the circular path. N means number of turns. I means current flowing. X means distance from the center. Distance from the center. So this is the magnetic field value. Remember this thing. So as you are moving away from the center, X value is increasing. X value increasing. Automatically magnetic field decreases. X value increasing. Automatically magnetic field decreases when we are moving away from the center like this. If X is increasing, magnetic field decreases. Remember this formula, this is important. And this continuation, one more case is there. Suppose if this point P is at the center, point P is at the center. So then what will happen? If P is at the center, then what is the value of X? P is at the center, the value of X. But X is measured from the center only. But point P is now at the center, then X value becoming 0. Then what is the magnetic field value? How it will change? So this is on the axial line, on the axis. This is the magnetic field on the axis, remember. So this is the magnetic field on the axis. So denominator mein you can write B suffix X like this. B suffix X. B suffix S. Now magnetic field at the center. Now magnetic field at the center. Remember carefully. So as per my this diagram, so if point P is at the center of O, so this is the case one. This is the next case. Next case kya hai? If P is at the center, point P is at the center of this circular loop. That means X value becoming 0. X value becoming 0. X value becoming 0. Then magnetic field B is equal to mu 0. Ni r square by 2 of r square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. In this, put x equal to 0. The formula is mu 0 ni r square by 2 of x is 0. So this is r square whole power 3 by 2 is there. 2 gets cancelled, r cube is remaining. You will get this is mu 0 ni r square by 2 cancel. I told you this is r cube is remaining. Here r square, here r cube, 1 r square will cancel, 1 r will remain. So magnetic field B is equal to mu 0 ni by r square cancel again. So 2. So here r square cancel, 1 r is remaining. So this is the answer. Mu 0 ni by 2 r. Say, bolo, what is this N here? Capital N, I am taking number of turns. Sir, there is only one turn is there. Okay, N equal to 1. Two turns are there, N equal to 2, no problem. So, this is the magnetic field at the center. Very, very, very important point. Magnetic field at the center. And I told you already, see this formula on the axis. See this formula at the center. See this formula on the axis. See this formula on the axis and center. I told you if X value is increasing, magnetic field is decreasing. But here there is no X term. So magnetic field is maximum at the center of current carrying circular loop. So it is maximum at the current carrying, maximum at the center of current carrying circular loop. Listen carefully. So at the center of this current carrying circular loop, magnetic field is maximum. Magnetic field is maximum. Now, in the final exam, they are asking a graph between the magnetic field on y-axis. So, magnetic field on y-axis like this, which is varying with the distance from the center. Distance from the center with the x, na? Here, distance from the center like this. Distance from the center. Distance from the center. I told you just now. Distance from the center. I told you. If we are moving away from the center, so X is increasing, then magnetic field decreases. but at the center, that means x equal to 0, at the center here, so magnetic field is maximum. Magnetic field is maximum, listen carefully. Here magnetic field is maximum, okay, na, at the center. If you are moving to the edges, na, so magnetic field falls down. So here magnetic field is maximum. Here magnetic field is maximum.